install a Leisure Roman 23 fiberglass pool today. And you can see we have the pool laid off here. We are going to begin excavation shortly. We have our machine en route. The pool's en route. Should arrive around lunchtime. And what we have here is our outline of the pool that you can see. And each one of these hash marks that you can see going down the side of the pool represents a depth of excavation. We've got our transit set up here. We have our dig sheets. You can see each line going through the pool there represents a depth. And that's a hash mark on the ground. We have our elevations that we've calculated and set. And we're ready to go as soon as the machine gets here. Got our hole dug, fully excavated, and the guys are now setting the pins in the floor of the pool, represent the corners of the floor there, and on those pins they are shooting grades, and they're going to run a string line down between the pins to represent the top of the gravel that creates the base of the pool there. Alright, we're getting our gravel down in our hole, taking it out, taking our gravel right up to the top of that string, screed it to make it level. That's how we establish the floor of the pool. We found the gravel is definitely the best material to use underneath the pool because it doesn't shift when it gets wet and it compacts immediately. As you can see here, our piece of pipe is a very rigid piece of pipe, not very flexible at all. In about a minute and a half, we're going to turn that into a big piece of 2-inch spaghetti. Have it. There's our piece of pipe that about 3 minutes ago was stiff as a board and couldn't have bend it if we wanted to. Now it's wrapped right around that pool. Alright, we are 100% ready to set our pool in the hole. Got our hole dug, bottom prepped, pool plumbed and hooked up to the excavator. And now comes the fun part. see our spreader bar there. That's the mechanism we use to distribute the pressure on the pool evenly so it doesn't put too much inward pressure on the pool shell. Now, there's a couple things we're looking for here when we set this pool. We have to make sure, first of all, that it's set exactly in the right spot. So we're gonna do a rough set and then check measurements to make sure the pool is centered on that building there, which is what we're looking for in this case. We have to also check to make sure the pool is level, which is actually can turn into quite a process sometimes, but luckily we're a leisure pool dealer and their shells are 99% one set shells. Don't worry, buddy. What's your name?
Justin,
this is your pool, right?
Yep.
You excited?
Yeah.
Awesome stuff, huh?
I got a lot done in one day.
Great, Justin. Thanks, man. And the third thing we need to check for that we'll see after we get the pool set in the right place is to make sure that the floor of the pool is on solid ground and that no portion of the pool floor is floating in any way so that we are on a solid foundation. Okay, we've squared the pool up with this building. It's perfectly centered. Now Billy's walking around on the floor of the pool to make sure that the entire floor is solid on gravel. You can see Billy's walking around. The pool's not shaking around. There's virtually no voids at all. The entire pool is sitting on gravel, and so that's good. That's what we're looking for. So we're now checking the pool for level. You can see Billy has our laser level going over there. With this pool, well, with any pool really, our industry standards are to try to get the pool within an inch of being level in 40 feet. We shoot for a half inch as a maximum tolerance. In case you're wondering what that white pipe is, we install a sump pipe on every single pool, and the purpose being to allow access to groundwater around the excavation. So we're going to cut that pipe off flush with the top of the concrete, and we're going to put another skimmer lid on top of that. So you're going to have, this client's going to have their skimmer lid there, and then from on top of the deck anyway, it's going to look like another skimmer lid at that place. At any point, we can remove that lid and drop a pump down in that pipe to pump groundwater out. And the only time we would ever need to do that is if we needed to drain this pool, and it just gives us access to groundwater.